What a piece of junk.
Hey, we're back again with issue 38, 39 and 40 of Build the Millennium Falcon. Which means this is video 38, 39 and 40. As I said, we're going to combine three issues simultaneously in one video because in single issue at this moment is far too little actual construction to warrant a complete video diary. This particular set of issues is rather important. This combines a rather important aspect of the Millennium Falcon itself, which I will discuss in a few minutes. I'm not quite sure if we're going to continue in this manner for the next weeks after issue 40. So it could be that issue 41 could be a single episode. I'm not sure. Maybe we're going to combine two. But for now, this is a video combining three issues. And let's go straight into the issues themselves. The Sentinel class landing craft, which is not the one from Return of the Jedi, but I believe you see it very briefly in the expanded edition of episode 4, and you see it later in games and in animated series. Sentinel species of Endor, apart from the Ewoks, there are apparently other species on that world. What's this? Oh, the repulsor lifts, in this case of the Millennium Falcon, where they're located. We come to the construction, which I will skip for now. We go straight into issue 39, the VX-100 freighter, the Ghost. I've never seen that ship in the films, or probably only in the animated series, but I could be wrong. Oh yes, it is in an animated series. It looks a bit like a Falcon. The Hoth asteroid belt and the cargo handling, including a cargo elevator on the Falcon, which was never seen, but it is supposed to be there. The construction set section, which I will skip for now. And issue 40, which is a important issue when it comes to construction, and I'll show you in a few minutes. First, we look at General Grievous' starfighter, which, as far as I know, is not seen in the films, but probably in the animated series. Looks a bit like a Messerschmitt jet fighter from World War II, the 263, I believe, or the 363, or the 262. Correct me on that, okay? Wildlife on Utapau. Didn't we visit Utapau a few issues back? Well, and combat techniques, dog fighting, not something the Falcon is known to do, and the construction of the Falcon. Let's go straight into construction. The reason why I'm now combining issue 38, 39 and 40 is because we are going to construct something, a rather vital element of the Falcon itself. Last week we had the lights for the ramp, and this week we're going to install the lights for the ramp, and we're going to install the hinge for the ramp itself, which we're going to need some oil for, and as far as I can see, some thread lock. Straight into step 39, which will include the engine, the ramp motor, and a rather ingenious but labor-intensive and nerve-wracking construction of the entire mechanism for opening and lowering the ramp. So that's going to be a bit more intensive than just gluing on some actuators. And stage 40, which will continue installing the engine and the hinges into the frames, but, and that is important, then connecting the engine into the existing frame, which will complete the entire bottom assembly. I believe that is a rather intensive piece of construction. Let's go straight into looking at the parts. And I have to be exceptionally secure now that I will not misplace any of these parts, because there are a lot of them in these three bags and they're quite small. These are some fragile looking hinges and actuators, the ramp itself, some metal pieces, the hinges, some details which also would not be misplaced, and some excruciatingly small looking pieces of metal which are very, very small. So this is something we need to take care of. A piece of paper can go to the place where paper is supposed to go, the incinerator. So let's place everything back and let's be exceptionally careful now, because I cannot afford to lose a single piece of this entire ramp construction set. So let's make sure that it is secured safe. Issue 39 only has, as far as I can see, one part included, apart from the piece of paper. Oh, and some metal rods. This is packaged in a separate container to avoid any damage. So I'll just leave it in here, which is the engine, the motor for the ramp itself. I will place everything back as soon as possible and make sure that I'll store all these parts in a safe place. This was issue 39, and finally issue 40, which also contains some rather small parts, which I will show you in a few seconds. Apart from the piece of paper, some plastic, very fragile pieces of plastic, which I believe is the gunnery section. Some glass for the cockpit, which probably will not be used. Some small screws and parts, and a piece of hole plating, which has a hole in the middle, because this is where the connector will go for the power supply for the Falcon. Something I will probably be replacing, because this hole for the power supply is rather close to where you can see it. I want to place it somewhere else, but that is for later. What I need to do now is to be absolutely very secure in starting the construction of the ramp and the ramp motor and the ramp mechanics. And in order to do so, I will gently put everything in the back and go straight to my workbench, and let's go start building this engine block. Compared to the last couple of weeks, we are now actually doing something. We are now going to assemble the movable ramp. And in order to do so, we will require an enormous amount of very teeny tiny little pieces. So you can see it. So before I'm going to open this bag and make sure that those tiny little pieces are collected somewhere, hold on, in this container. So let me open up the bag first. Be very careful, because if I lose any of these pieces, I'm royally flunked. No, well, you know what I'm talking about. Let me carefully put those pieces over here, all of them. Not quite sure I'm going to use them right now, but let me see. And most definitely, I have to make sure that these pieces are not missing. There are four of them in this small bag. Okay, that's it. Okay, now let's see what we need to do, because this is going to be, the first part is not that difficult. The first thing we need to do is install the lights for the ramp. And in order to do so, we will need, here we are. This I got from issue 37, if you can remember, the light strip. This is the frame we've built in a couple of weeks ago, and what we need to do is, let's see carefully, working from the top, let's first remove the metal band. Okay, working for the top, carefully fit the lighting strip into this hole in the frame. And this is, let me see, let me increase the size of the photo, because I can do that as I am using this little device over here, my tablet, so I can actually now zoom into the picture. Okay, that's it. Feed the circuit all the way through until you reach the start of the wiring, which I've just done. Go back. Then turn the assembly over, like this, I believe. Yes. I have to do it like this. I have to be very careful when I'm doing this correctly, because I cannot afford any mistakes. And then I have to place it like this. Okay. So we remove the back from this light, because it is a has some glue on the back of the light strip itself. Okay, and we need to glue the lights in over here. Okay, that is the first section of the build. Let's zoom out, because now we go into the hydraulic systems, and I have to be very careful what I'm going to do right now. Let me remove this part for a minute, and let's go to the next part. We're going to prepare the ramp. This is the movable ramp, as you can see. We need to glue some things onto that. Most notably, we need to glue in, let me see where it is. Is it this part? Yes, I believe it is this part. Let me open up this bag. We need to fill the ramp extension, part 4. I'm not quite sure if it's marked on the plastic, but as far as I believe, oops, this must be what they're talking about. Let me just replace all these in a box. So it would seem I have to do it like this. So at the end of the ramp, so that the two small lugs on the ramp fit in a mirror in the recesses. Ah, yes, there are some pins over here which allow this ramp to move. Test fit the ramp extension, part 5. This is part 5. I need to glue part 5 onto part 4. But make sure that glue only comes connected to... Oh, my glue is nearly empty. The glue is only coming over here and not in the part where it's going to be moving. So add some glue, and then I have to make sure that the ramp is in the position. Then I need something to put it into position. That should be it. So what we have now is, this is the ramp with the ramp extension, and apparently you can then fold in the ramp like this. Before we can do anything right now, we need to paint this part of the ramp, the so-called walk path, walkway. It's optional, but it is advised to do it now before any further construction, because we probably won't be able to reach the parts after that. Looking at the pictures, I believe we can still reach all the parts, but let's do it by the book. Let's paint this one first, and before I can actually paint it, I will need to mask off this section over here. This should not be painted. So the only thing we need to paint is between these lines, complete with the ramp extension which we just glued in. So I loaded up the airbrush and let's put a little paint on the ramp. So the paint has dried, so now let me remove the masking tape. Let's start with the center one. That looks good. Come on, that's good. And remove these sections. Okay. Let's see, I did have some slight overspray unfortunately over here, but I think I'm gonna paint the rest of the model anyway, so let's see what this will bring us in the end. Hold on, it's more stuck than it was supposed to be. Okay, let me move from the back first. Okay. Yeah, I got some overspray in the back as well. But once again, I believe that we do not have any visible elements over there anyway. Okay, that is the gangplank. I'm gonna keep the gangplank like it is right now. I'm not gonna do anything else with it. Now I need to glue on these parts. Oh, there you are. Now I need to glue on these parts. Let me first change the camera angle a bit. So at least you can see me. Here we are. Okay, let's see where they need to go. I can see where it is. Okay, I need to add the glue over here into these little slots. I need to replace my glue. Yes, I need to replace the glue. I've checked them, they're secured in place, so now it's time to go to step one, assembling the hinge, and that is the first of many tiny little objects which I need to fix. I just bought myself a bottle of Loctite. Always happens when I'm doing something, I've suddenly got an itch on my finger. Okay. So we screw these two in firmly. Oops, firmly. Come on. Firmly. Okay. Turn it around and do the same thing on the other side. I have screwed in both the left and the right hinge, and I did use some Loctite, by the way. I just loosened the screws a little bit, put some Loctites in there, and screwed it again. Great. So we go on to part four, and this is where we actually do need to put the Loctite in. What we need to do is get these parts connected using the same screws, but we need to use the Loctite for this. So, and that is not going to work that easily, but there is some Loctite over here which I just spilled, so I might be using this. And see if we can get it in the hole. Yes. And the other one. Okay. Make sure this thing still works. The finish hinge should look like this. Hold on. Okay, it's moving a bit. Here is with BP13. So what we need to do is test fit this thing over here, which of course will fit. And it is quite obvious now I need to
screw the two together like this, if I'm not incorrect. I am not incorrect. Like this. Let me test it. Yes, okay. I probably will be needing, let's see if I can see which screws I will be needing for this. Yes, the silver self-tapping screws, which are these. I need 8 of them, by the way. So, let me screw these 8 in and I'll get back to you as soon as we're finished. And the last one is in. Okay, let's see if this works perfectly. Very smooth, yes. Well, the ramp itself, of course, has a particular weight, so it'll lower down by itself. That will be completing episode 38. And episode 39, which we're coming in now, will be including the engine. Because it's the motor, this is actually the only part which is included in this issue. Let me remove it from the plastic. And there are 2 very small of these things in here. Just let them put them aside and let's get out the motor. With its connector. Do not try to power up the ramp motor until you receive the external control board. Well, I'm not going to try to power up the engine, don't worry. Actually installing the engine until the last part of the build of episode 39. Let me show you a bit what we're going to do in stage 39. Hold on, we're going to use all these and we're going to have to put up all these things together. So that is going to take some reading ahead. Let me put the engine aside, or the motor aside, and let's read what we need to do. We have to assemble 4 of these actuators, and I've already made these 2. These are the shorter ones. And we do the same thing, but then the longer ones. So we have these longer plastic pieces, the longer actuators, and the longer metal rods. It's actually quite simple how you do it. You push the metal rod through the plastic, like this. And then we glue a bit of the tip of the metal rod. It's not necessary, but it might be better if we do. And then push in the metal in the plastic actuator. And we'd probably be needing some pliers to gently twist them in there. Let's see if I'm correct. Okay, we have to be very careful that they don't break the plastic. Okay, that's 1. And that's about to be number 2. Once again, I will be needing some pliers to gently wiggle them in. Okay, so that's those 4 actuators finished. 2 long and 2 shorts. And what now need to be done is I need to fix these little thingamajigs onto here using these extremely small, and let's see if I can find them, not these I believe, but using these. And I have now installed this little thingy, which is quite difficult, but let me show you how it's done. Okay, I have 1 of the actuators, it doesn't make any difference which one, and I have this one over here. This hold on. This connector. So what we are supposed to do is we take one of these extremely small metal rods, take a bit of masking tape and roll it on one side of the pliers with the sticky side up. We use some of these. As you can see, like this. Take one of the actuators, then okay. Use the same plier and firmly push them together. And if you did it correctly, the connection is made. Let me try that again. So take a bit of masking tape, stick it in one of the pieces of the plier. Take one of those teeny little, tiny little metal rods. No! What happened when I was taking one of these very teeny tiny little pins, and they are extremely tiny, you can see them over here, just the metal one over there. One of those little teeny tiny things managed to jump from my pliers, and I couldn't find it. I was crawling on the floor for about an hour using a magnet, and I couldn't find it. So what I eventually did was take a piece of plastic, a plastic piece from a different model kit, and what I did, I hope you can see it, hold on, I used a piece of plastic, I stuck it in, and on the other side I glued it onto the movable pin. So it's not perfect, but it's all I could do, unfortunately. So what we have to do now is attach the ramp, which is just made, to the frame, and we have to do that using these screws. So I have here the frame, sorry, I have here the frame, this is the ramp piece. So I'm gonna find the connector pins, which are over here, and let's see now, because I had some ideas. And that finished the 8th screw. Okay, this part of the frame, of the whole plating, has now been fixed to the frame position. And as you can see, the ramp goes up and down, or in this case, of course, goes up and down. See? Now, the next part of the instructions suggests to install the ramp motor. Once you've done that, you will not be able to open up the ramp by hand anymore until the motor has been attached to the battery box and the circuit board, which is going to be in a very long time, about several months from now. However, before I'm going to do that, I want to make a small modification. I know there are several modifications for sale which will require you to saw out this entire section and install an interior in these in this quarter. So when you open up the ramp and you look inside, you can actually see inside the ship, and you can look to the you can see the corridor, the wind corridor in the back. I'm not going to do that because that ramp modification is quite expensive. What I am going to do, however, is I'm going to put some styrene plastic along this line here, so that when the ramp is open and you look like you watch like this, you can see a bit of a styrene wall, which is instead of these metal strips. So I'm going to do that first, glue in that piece of styrene, and maybe later fix some greebles along that styrene sheet. But for now, I'm just going to measure up the styrene and stick it into place. So what I've done is I made two pieces of styrene, as you can see, for the side walls and one for the ceiling, although of course in normality the ceiling would be far higher. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to take this piece of styrene and stick it over here, and then most likely going to paint it black, so you will have the illusion that you're looking at the ceiling. And these pieces are going to come along the walls of the ramp entrance over here, and these are going to be painted gray and later perhaps with some greebles along it, so it looks like it's the wall of the sidewall of the ramp entrance. Let me put off the camera first and let's glue them in, and I'll show you the end result. So I have finished gluing in the parts and I have given them a lick of paint. And of course the black still requires a little bit of layer, but this is what I have made. So yeah, it's not of course as good as the modification you can buy, but well, this one was a lot cheaper. So three strips of styrene and a lick of paint. Okay, we're on to the next part of the build, which is in this case installing the motor. Okay, after the mild disaster of the little metal pivots, we have these, which are a bit larger, and there are two of them. As far as I can see, we only need one. So why they use a spare of the larger ones and not one of the smaller ones is beyond me, but oh well. The next part is we have to take this little part, which was the last one on the sprue, and we need to have that inserted on this part of the motor. So let me open up the bag carefully above this box just in case, and take out one of these pivots. As you can hear, I have already put the second one in the box. Okay, so what's going to happen now? We need to make sure that this is in place, and then we need to insert the pivot into place. I'm not going to use a pliers this time. I don't think there's no top and no bottom of this pin. Alright, let's see. That goes in very easily, I must say. I'm probably going to use some super glue just in case, or maybe it doesn't. No, it's not necessary. No super glue is necessary. Well, as you can see, it's in. And now we need to glue this bottom section of this pivot, or whatever it's called, and have it glued right over there on the spot where we didn't paint it. And doing so, we need to make sure that the motor, and that is oriented like this. So we simultaneously we need to glue it into place and then screw it into place. Let's do that right now. Some drops of super glue. And just to be certain, I'm going to add some drops of super glue on the ramp section as well to make sure that it is in place, because this is the only connection the motor has with the ramp itself. So here goes nothing. I have to make sure that it's in place. Actually, I can't really see if it's in place. I have to assume it's in place. It is in place. Okay, now make sure that I do not move the motor any more than this. I'm going to screw it into place, and I believe I have to use these black screws. Yes, the black screws to fix the motor into its position on the frame, so make sure that it doesn't move anymore. Okay, the motor is now in place. Four of those black screws have been used. And to make sure if everything is in place, as far as I can see, yes, I can see through the tiny slot over here that the pivot is glued onto the ramp itself. With that done, we're now going to fix those actuators which we've made. And we have to first find out, we have to use the long one first. I made a lot of stupid boo-boo. Remember how I glued in that ceiling for the ramp? Yeah, that was stupid because these actuators need to go through here and glued to the ramp, and with the ceiling in I couldn't reach the connector point. Okay, so I removed the ceiling and kept the sidewalls because those can stay in. I think they can stay in. Let me see if they can stay in, because now I have the feeling that these have been removed as well. Yeah, these have to be removed as well, the sidewalls. Well, at least the sidewalls over here. So let me remove those sidewalls. Okay, I have also removed these bits over here from the sidewalls. Yes, I should really pay better attention. Okay, let's start by gluing in the first of the actuators. Now, what we have to do, and I have taken steps to do so, you have to isolate, you have to identify which goes where. Now, this one has the connector pivot on the left, on the right, sorry, on the right, and this has to, this one has to go over here. So what we need to do is glue in that pivot thing onto the ramp, and then use the black screws and screw in this piece over here. So let's do that. Let's take some glue. Some super glue on these sides as well. Okay, make sure it's oriented the right way. And that it is stuck in position. We use some pointy pliers to do it, make sure it is. I believe it is. And prevent it damaging, I will straight on screw in the other section of the actuator. This is a bit of fiddly work. Let me find the hole. There she goes. Okay, she's still in one place? Yes, she's still in one piece. Okay, that one is in one of the two screws. Now all we need to do is put the other screw in, and then continue doing this until all the actuators are in place. And now we arrive at the final step of this episode. We are now in issue 40, and what we're going to do now is we're going to fix the ramp pleated frame in the existing frame we already have. And in order to do that, we'll first need to add about, let's see what we're going to do. We need one over here and one over here and one over here of those two hole connectors. So let's do this first. We don't need any hole connectors on the other side because we already have connectors on the radial ribs. So let's get us three last of the two-hole connectors out there, and we're going to need, of course, the black screws and the screwdriver. Right, let's first add the two-hole connectors to the ramp section of the frame. I'm not going to put them in very hard, screw them in very hard. I'm going to screw them in a bit loose so that they're a bit flexible. Okay, that's in. Now we're still going to need those black screws. Let me see if I can actually remove that for a minute. Now we are going to be installing the frame itself. Let's see, and we do that by just putting it on top over here and underneath the ring on in the back. Well, it seems pretty obvious where the screws are going to go in. Let's check first. Start, let's see, where are we supposed to start? First the outmost, then this one, then the inner, and then the ring itself, which then over here. Okay, we have to go just like this then. Okay. Now, I'm not going to film all the screws, but when we finish, I'll be back. And this is the last one, which is in, right. That means that the entire bottom frame is now complete, all except the two mandibles in front, but those will be added later. And it also means that I have now finished with issue 40, and it means that this episode is also finished. Well, this was a hair-raising, nerve-wrenching episode where almost everything that could go wrong did go wrong. The only thing we now hope is that the ramp is still working, but we can't find it out until the engine is connected to the circuit board, and well, the circuit board is not installed yet. So I can turn it around so you can see. This is where the thing is in place. Oh, I have to be careful not to damage these things over here, the actuators themselves. I believe this is actually one of the last things I have to do on this frame until I'm going to screw in all the hole plating, which is going to be happening around issue 46, I assume. Well, that's it for me right now. I hope you've been nail-biting along with me. And I believe this was one of the most nail-biting episodes ever. So, thank you for watching, and we'll see each other next time, where we will be looking at constructing one of the gun turrets. See you then. Bye!